isn't it? Look at that. Whoa, he storm hurdles a man at the 31. Oh, to the 25, they got him. They got... No! He slips the tackle at the 19. He's off. To the 10, 5, one man to beat. He's in for the score. Panthers win. The Panthers win an unbelievable finish here today, folks. Panthers win 15-14 with no time remaining on that clock. What a game.
Did you see that? Storm wouldn't be denied. Let me tell you something. Kansas State better watch out.
Hey, Barney, what's up?
Hey, John.
Car ready?
All ready. Over there.
All right, Barney.
Okay. Hey, hold on a second. I want to tell you something.
What's going on?
1958, Louisiana State, Billy Cannon versus Ole Miss. Score 3-0, Ole Miss. 4 seconds left on the clock. Hi, honey, how you doing?
Hey, Sally.
4 seconds on the clock. They punt the ball to Billy Cannon. He runs through 8 guys, 80 yards for a touchdown, wins the game 6-3. Greatest collegiate game I ever saw and the greatest run, except for yours today.
Oh, come on.
No, I'm not kidding. I only wish your father were here to see it.
When I was 15, they told my mother there was a tumor growing in my brain. The tumor gave me severe migraines, so the doctors put me on painkillers. Percodan, Lorazep, Vicodin, Darvocet, Oxycontin. After a while, I could barely hold a conversation. Still, the migraines kept getting worse. Finally, my mom took me to a specialist in Canada. He prescribed an herb that actually worked. I got off the drugs, and after a few months, the tumor in my brain actually began to shrink. Getting my prescription filled was still a problem at times.
What the fuck are you looking for?
I'm looking for Reggie. Are you Reggie?
Do I look like a fucking Reggie to you?
What the fuck, man? Sorry, bro, nothing personal.
I ain't your bro. Round the corner, take a right. Look for the first phone.
Thanks. Hey, are you Reggie?
What's the note?
Relax, man. I'm just here to shop.
Oh, look. Shop for food. What do you need?
An ounce. I want the chronic.
Hold on. $350.
Here you go, man. Thanks a lot, bro. Take care.
Okay, kid, freeze! Hands in the air, nice and slow. You are under arrest. You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say, cannon will be used in the court of law.
Freeze, dirtbag! Turn around,
you bastard.
You all right, partner?
I can't feel my legs, Dave. I can't feel my fucking legs.
Shit. Central, this is Eagle One.
Go ahead, Eagle One.
Now, Eagle One, I've got an officer down at 6th and Freedom. I want an ambulance now. I repeat, officer down.
I thought I was the bad brother. I gotta go take care of Mom. You gonna be all right? Take care of yourself, brother.
Thank you.
like shit, man.
What do you expect? Your Reggie boy was a narc, man. Why'd you send me to him?
It wasn't him. I found out the night before he got popped. Cops were using his place to run a sting op. You didn't say anything about me, did you?
No, of course not.
So what are you looking at?
3 to 5 years.
What?
The cop's paralyzed from the waist down.
That's fucking insane.
Tell me about it.
Well, is there anything I can do? Get you a lawyer or something?
No. Sentence is mandatory. Even a judge can't do anything about it.
The scariest thing about prison is not getting beat up or raped. It almost never happens. The really scary thing is how life goes on without you. Almost like you were never there. The day I got locked up actually started out as the best day of my life. We were playing Allegheny State. Down, late in the fourth.
Johnson takes the kick. He's buried. That's where the Panthers will start out, down 14-9 with only 56 seconds remaining and one timeout. First and 10, coming up. Panthers need 6 points.
That's right, Ken, but for that to happen, the offense is going to have to pull it together and show us something they haven't today. A touchdown.
42.
Here's Bronson coming to the line. Takes the snap. Oh, here's a man open downfield. And, oh, overthrown incomplete pass.
And that's been the story all day. The receivers are getting open, but Bronson just isn't getting them the ball.
Is that in the playbook? Come on, boy.
Second and 10, coming up. Here's the play at the line. It's another pass. It's picked off by number 6.
No, he dropped it.
All right, Johnny. It's up to you. I'm putting you in. You want it your shot, I go out there and make something happen.
Make something happen, Storm.
Bronson, out right now.
You know, the Panthers really got lucky on that play. Let's see if they can capitalize.
And looky here. We have a substitution. It looks like number 2, Jonathan Storm, is coming in to replace Bronson, the quarterback.
You know, the coaches really can't say enough good things about this kid. He's got great speed, but I must admit, this is a surprise. I think we may be seeing a little desperation here from Coach Thomas with the season and probably his job on the line.
Let me get that dive package in here. All right, fellas, let's go. Good job, good job.
All right, option left on 1. Option left on 1. Ready?
Break!
Clock down to 36 seconds now. And they come up with a handoff over the left side. And no, the freshman keeps the ball. He moves ahead. First down, a pickup of 7 big yards. Clock continues to run. Panthers back to the line in a hurry. Storm takes the snap, rolls to his left. He hits Dyson on the two out. He's knocked out of bounds at the 24-yard line after a pickup of 32 yards on the play. Big thing is, he stops the clock.
And that wasn't the prettiest pass I've seen, but I must say, he's getting it done. The Panthers are right back in it.
They should go for the end zone here. Grizzlies showing blitz.
Blitz!
Oh, this time they get it for a loss. Storm goes down hard at the 28, and Coach Thomas wants a timeout here.
Complete domination by the Grizzlies' defense. That time they brought out everyone, and they double-covered the hot receiver. Storm didn't have a chance.
That was a big play for them, Jimmy. They want to shake this young quarterback's confidence.
Get that Packer. He's killing me, man.
Don't worry, I get him.
Flood on 1. Flood on 1. Ready?
Bring!
Panthers come to the line.
And the Panthers have got 1, maybe 2 plays left. They need to get into the end zone now.
Oh, Grizzly showing blitz.
And they're going to come after him again. They figure it worked once. Why not try it again? Let's see if the line can give him a little more protection this time.
Red 19. Red 19. Hut!
Storm takes a snap.
drops back, looking for the pass. He shakes a tackle. He rolls to his right. Slips another tackle. Now he's coming back left. There's no one open.
And he's keeping it. Yeah. Look at that.
Oh, he storm hurdles a man at the 31. Oh, to the 25. They got him. They got... No. He slips the tackle at the 19. He's off. To the 10, 5, one man to beat. He's in for the score. Panthers win. The Panthers win. An unbelievable finish here today, folks. Panthers win 15-14 with no time remaining on that clock. What a game.
Did you see that? Storm wouldn't be denied. Let me tell you something. Canton State better watch out next week, because something tells me they may be in for some stormy weather. Do you know what I mean, Ken?
I had my bumps in the road, but I ain't getting done. By the way, I went and saw your mom's last week.
So how's she?
Getting bad, but she missing you, G. Whole family on blast about the way it went down. Trying to say that you deserve what you're going through now.
Watch the haters, they only want to see you fall. That's what got me hemmed up behind these concrete walls.
If you want to make it on the inside, you have to get into a routine. After a year, people stop coming to see you. After two, a lot of them stop accepting collect calls. Only Alex would come and see me at least once a month. People would ask me, if she was locked up and you were out there, what would you be doing? Which didn't help my state of mind much. Scoring butt inside was expensive, but I managed. Then one day, they dropped a bomb on me. The police officer I had injured made a full recovery. After only 2.5 years, I was recommended for early parole.
Oh, man, don't be stupid, partner. I mean, you about to get up out of here, you know?
I know.
You know what? Just make sure I don't see you back up in here, okay?
Hey, you know I ain't no criminal, man.
Hey, I'm innocent, too. They had to frame me to get me caught up. But now I know, you want to stay in the gang, you got to work with five of them. I'll be like that one. My cousin was working for this dude, right? And he was moving crazy weight. Never got busted. Not at all. And dude calls it plutonium.
What?
The powder, man. He calls it plutonium. He runs his club, the reactor. They say you can get your plutonium straight from the reactor.
Well, what is it, man?
Partner got his own pharmacy. You know what I'm saying? E, meth, and you name it. Get through it. And he never get busted. Not at all. My cousin, that motherfucker got popped. But this dude never went down. Yeah. Y'all, dude connected. Got to be. No doubt about it.
Prisoner Aguilera, you have a meeting with your attorney. Prisoner Aguilera.
Was a little baby. Sitting on his daddy's knee, yeah. He looked over yonder, saw a little piece of steel. So that steel's gonna be the death of me, Lord, Lord. Steel's going to be the death of me. Well, that boy grew up to be a steel driver, strongest.
So how's mom?
Same old shit. I keep fighting about my lifestyle.
Oh yeah, what happened with you and Gabriella?
We broke up. Found her in the sack with Jimmy.
Little Jimmy?
Yeah, little Jimmy.
Ouch.
I know. Messed me up, man. I was gonna kill myself on their wedding day.
You're shitting me.
I was gonna do it. I was headed up into the attic. I was gonna hang myself. Mom saved my life.
She cut you down?
She wanted to watch. I got embarrassed. It's been good, though. You know, it's been good because it's been good for my music, the pain, the anger. I got a new singer. Oh, my God, you got to see this girl. Just wait till you see her. I mean, this girl, she's got a body that was put together by somebody very friendly with the devil.
You talking marriage?
I don't know about that.
Well, John Henry, he said to the captain, a man ain't
Here's the tracking devices. Don't forget to turn them on, okay?
Okay.
I made Eric swear not to tell anyone I was getting out early. I wanted to believe that Alex had been faithful to me, but I had to know. Waiting to surprise her, I wondered, what if she had been with someone else? Was I willing to end it? It occurred to me that I really didn't have much to offer.
Is your mom home?
Yeah, is your roommate home?
Yeah. So where are we gonna go?
I don't know. I think I'm gonna explode.
Hey, Barney.
Hey, bird's out of the cage, huh?
You know, you got to stop looking so damned attractive. I'm beginning to have evil thoughts.
Easy, Pops.
Well, we'll deal with that later.
So what do you need?
Just came to say hi.
What else?
And I need some wheels.
Real vehicle, $600. Tell you what, you get it tagged and insured, you pay me $100 a month. You got a deal?
Deal.
Thanks, Barney.
Well, you know, I've always kind of liked you two, and I'm glad you stuck it out together. Now, me and the missus, we've been married. Oh, that reminds me, there's something I want to show you. Come on this way.
John, remember that DEA officer who busted you?
Dave Blake?
Dave Blake. Alex, take a seat over there, please. Well, guess what? He's my neighbor, four houses down the street.
You're shitting me.
No, I wouldn't do that. My favorite bird. I didn't even know he was a narc until I saw him at your trial. Small world, ain't it? Pictures, pictures. My wife's always taking pictures. Ah. Now, she took these on the day that you went down. Okay, ready?
Go.
Ah. Nice one of the kids, eh? That's Blake right there in the background, white hair.
Who's the other guy?
You're getting ahead of me. I had it blown up. Hey? Hey? Ring a bell?
What the fuck are you looking at?
What do you expect? Your Reggie boy was a narc, man. Why'd you send me to him?
The powder, man. He calls him plutonium. He runs his club, the Reactor. They say you can get your plutonium straight from the Reactor. But now I know, you want to stay in the gang, you got to work with five of them, like that one. Did you do it?
Christ!
Do what, man?
I saw the picture of you and the cop from the day I got busted.
Look, man, I don't know what the fuck you're talking about.
Was it to get my spot on the team? Plutonium, huh?
Don't touch the gun.
Sure, boss.
Give me a plastic bag. I want you to go follow him. I want to know every single move he makes.
Let's get it done, boss.
Napkin.
He's at the cop shop now. What do you want me to do?
I want you to go get him, and I want you to tell him that I made a mistake, and I'm sorry. But I also want you to tell the son of a bitch that if he snitches me out to the cops, I will bite the bullet, and I will do my time. But when I get out, I will find him, and I will peel his skin off, drink his blood, fuck his woman, put a bullet in her head, and I'll eat his children.
You want me to tell him all that?
Do it.
I can't. He just left.
This is where I grew up, once the largest Hare Krishna community in the world. My parents gave up all their material possessions to serve Sri Radha and Krishna and live close to the land. When I was 9 years old, I was sent to India to be trained as a future leader of the movement. When I returned, I had no taste for spiritual life. I told my parents I was going away to college to lead a normal life. My father was devastated. He expected me to remain behind and help build the community. When I refused, he sent me from his house, warning of oncoming disaster. That would be the last time we spoke.
All I'm saying is that at this stage of your life, you're having an affair with this young woman. I cannot approve.
It's not an affair, Mother. It's a relationship.
Are you sleeping with that girl?
What the hell kind of a question is that to ask?
If you're not sleeping with her, it's a lousy thing to ask. If you are, it's a hell of a good question.
You know what? I'm not even going to dignify it with an answer.
Oh, yes, you are going to dignify it with an answer. You're going to answer me now because I asked you.
You know what? I don't want to answer it, so I'm not going to, okay? How's that?
You're going to talk to me right now.
Maybe I don't want to talk.
Hi, I'm Lisa. You're Jonathan, I suppose? Is it always like this in your house?
Only when we're together.
At least you talk. My house is so quiet. Except when the TV's on. All right, I'm gonna leave you alone. I can see you came out here for some peace and quiet.
No, that's okay. You can stay, I mean. I'm sure they're gonna be like that a while.
Eric asked me to move in with them.
Oh, yeah?
Your mom thinks we should get married first.
Well, what do you think?
Who do you think put her up to this?
Bye. weeks. I mean, I'm doing the best I can without being obvious.
You don't have a couple of weeks, Pop. You got 2 days.
My roommate's gone for the weekend. We'll have a place to ourselves.
Great.
What's the matter?
I almost killed Dominic today.
You did what?
I just found out he's the one that set me up.
Oh, man. I should have known.
Known what?
Well, it was about 3 months after you went into prison, and he started calling me, and he kept showing up at work, and he kept hitting on me.
You did what?
I didn't even think for a second.
Son of a bitch! Did he ever touch you?
No.
You're sure?
Relax. Nothing happened, okay?
Can't fight getting older. You can't stay.
Yeah, boss.
We got ourselves a little problem.
Don't worry about the car. Did he make any phone calls? No, no. What I'm asking is if you saw him make any phone calls. No? Good. He left the truck at the Walmart? Even better. Just get your ass up here.
Jalu and I had grown up together in the ashram. We had not seen each other since I had left the temple. But when I told him my story, he agreed to help us. As long as he didn't have to lie, cheat, steal, or break the law. Urged us to say a prayer to Lord Nisringadev for protection. Tomorrow, we would need all the help we could get.
What's up?
This armored truck. How much money are we talking about?
At least 150 grand. Maybe two, right?
Huh. That's a whole lot of money.
Look, John, I'm still not sure I want to do this.
What did she say?
She's on the mental.
Well, we ain't got time for that. I already bought the bike.
He already bought the bike.
What is it with you? You've been out of prison for 2 days and you're trying to turn us all into criminals.
Look, I gotta go here, man. I gotta kiss some ass.
Chet, easy on the donuts, huh?
Kiss my ass.
Where are you going, Dave? You got a hot tip some kids are rolling up a fatty up at the lookout?
Bad joke, Miller. Actually, I got a couple of days off. The kids are at Grandma's, and Mama wants my body.
Ooh.
Just crawled out from under a rock. Did somebody flush that toilet you call a nightclub?
No, actually, I'm here to see you. I got something for you.
Look, punk, I don't like you. I made a mistake once and let you slide for some useless information. Whatever you got for me now better be bigger than some chicken shit pot bust.
Oh, it is.
What is it?
This.
Oh!
Nothing. I just had a bad dream. I gotta go. Can you give me a ride? My car's at the Walmart.
Take mine. It's my day off. I'm gonna sleep in.
That's not the plan.
I know. Just go. Come back and get me when you're ready.
Oh, I forgot. Your car's almost out of gas. Can I borrow some money?
Over there, in the middle drawer.
Shit!
Oh, don't worry. It's just a toy.
What the hell is it doing in there?
My roommate was going through my stuff. I wanted to surprise her.
Shopping yesterday for a book and a pen, a common poet's dear friend. A lazy old man with a bottle of booze, the only way to be
dead. How's it going, Barney?
Hey, John.
My.
What do you think?
What do you think I think? Hey, watch it. So, how's it going?
He's still changing the ignition switch in my car.
All right. Bring me the keys. There you go.
Man, Barney.
Yeah, I know. I suppose this is on credit, too, eh?
Yeah, that's so.
Oh, John.
Come here.
There's something I want to tell you.
Strange thing. Last night,
my neighbor Dave Blake, last night, shot to death 4 times to the chest. Big holes.
You're kidding me.
No. When he told his wife the news, she began howling and screaming like a banshee. Woke up the whole damn neighborhood. Kind of a shame. They had a couple of kids, you know. There'd been a cop killed in this town in, 20 years. Now the whole police department is up in arms about it. They think he was shot by one of the criminals he put in jail. Revenge or something.
Revenge? For what?
I don't know. It seems like something more than that to me.
I tried to forget about the dream. I knew that it was now or never, that if I hesitated, I would lose my chance. But I couldn't shake the feeling that something else was wrong. On the way home, I wondered if I should call the whole thing off. Barney had told me the cops were on red alert. On the other hand, they would be preoccupied. It might be a good distraction.
Hello?
Ma, what's going on?
John, the police are here. What have you done?
I didn't do anything, Ma.
Jonathan, where are you?
It doesn't matter where I am. What are you doing in my mother's house?
Well, why don't you come on in and we'll talk about it?
No, I want to talk about it now.
Look, you're suspect in the murder of Agent Dave Blake.
What?
We found a murder weapon in your truck, John. Your fingerprints were all over it. How much more you want to know?
Keep him talking.
Listen, John. Let's not make this more complicated than it needs to be. I need you to come in and we'll talk.
Hold it. First of all, I haven't shot a gun in years.
Well, I never said he was shot with a gun. I said murder weapon, John. I never mentioned a gun.
Someone told me about the murder.
Already? Look, John, I'm trying to be civil here. We could do this the easy way or the hard way. You decide, my friend. But I need you to come in, and we need to talk and let the chips fall where they will.
Excuse me, what's your name?
Lieutenant Corby, Homicide and Robbery Division.
Look, Lieutenant, I have a rock-solid alibi.
I spent the night with my girl.
Okay, good, good. This is good. This girl, she have a name, number?
Her name's Alexander Foster. The number's 555-8912.
Hiya. Now, John, I need you to stay on the line, okay? I need you to bear with me here, because we don't want to get the impression that you talked to her before we did.
Yeah, I'll hold.
I need a conference call with this number, 555-8912.
You're on.
All right, here we go. You with me, John?
Yeah, I'm here.
Hello?
Miss Alexander Foster?
This is she.
Yeah, look, this is Lieutenant Corby with the Wieland Police Department. We need to know when the last time you saw a person by the name of Jonathan Storm.
Last time I saw him was yesterday afternoon, and I haven't seen him since. He stole my car, and I was going to report it, but I was hoping he'd bring it back.
What?
What do you say, John? John? John!
Let's finish it.
Hey, let me go!
Wait, wait.
Help!
You gotta think this through, man.
Please.
What's to think through? Just put a bullet through the pillow.
Help!
The scenario, man. Her boyfriend comes here, he kills her. But then what?
He splits. He's a fugitive.
What's the one thing a fugitive needs most? Cash. He'd take all her cash, her jewelry, everything. You gotta do this right, otherwise the cops won't buy it.
Right. Where do you keep the rest of these at?
Please, let me go.
Tell me where they're at. We'll talk about it.
Over there in the second drawer.
come on, Alex. It's okay.
No, it's not. I've almost been killed 100 times in the last 5 minutes. My house is gone. There's a dead body in the trunk, and we're on the way to rob the place I work. These things are not okay.
I swear, once we get through this, I'll go completely legit.
Ever since you've been out of jail, my life has been pure hell, John.
Come on, Alex. There's no reason to cry.
I have the right to cry. Give me the right to cry.
At the beginning of every great endeavor, there is a catastrophe. While we were dealing with this one, phase one of our plan was going into effect.
This just in. Local police are seeking information leading to the apprehension of Jonathan Storm, a man just released from state prison. Storm is the prime suspect in the murder of a local narcotics officer. The police say that he is to be considered armed and extremely dangerous. If you have any information concerning this matter, the police are urging you to call the Crime Stoppers hotline now.
Can I give you a hand?
I don't know what happened. It just died on me.
Oh, no wonder it died on you. I mean, you're drop-dead gorgeous.
Stop it.
Nah, if you were to stop like this on the interstate, well, you'd have a traffic jam all the way to Pittsburgh.
Please.
Oh, I'm serious. You'd get arrested for looking that good.
You think so?
Oh, I don't just think so. I know it for sure. Well, let me try to start it for you. You got the keys?
They're in the ignition.
Wow. I don't know what to tell you. If you ask me, this car is dead as a brick. So where are you headed?
I'm going home. I live in Ogilby.
Well, I can give you a ride. I mean, that is if you want one.
I'd really appreciate it, if it's not too much trouble.
No, no trouble at all.
With an arson homicide. Police believe Storm is responsible for the fire that may have taken the life of Alexandra Foster, a witness for the prosecution. What is believed to be her charred remains was discovered after firemen extinguished the blaze that destroyed her home. Once again, Jonathan Storm, a suspected cop killer, is now wanted in connection with another murder. If you have any information, please call the Crime Stoppers hotline. Tim?
Hi, may I help you?
Yeah, I need a room.
Okay, do you take smoking or not smoking?
Non-smoking.
Okay. Oops, excuse me.
Mr. Zip.
Okay.
So, what's on the news?
Just same old stuff.
Got him.
Hey,
Would you mind lighting the candles, please?
You got it.
Cheers.
Cheers.
It's your turn.
What, you down yours just like that?
I didn't down it. It evaporated. I feel like smoking. You have a cigarette?
You know I don't smoke.
Then what are you feeling your pockets for?
I don't know. It's just that I'm out of cigarettes.
You mean you always fill your pockets when you're out of cigarettes?
No. Jesus. I don't even know how we got started on this.
We haven't started anything. Yet.
So, you like the Steelers?
No.
Football's not my thing either.
So are we gonna let this bottle sit here, or are we gonna turn it into a lamp?
Ah, I got it.
See you later.
John, if you don't go legit after this, I swear I'm gonna kill you.
I love you too, dear.
So I guess I know why you invited me up here tonight.
Oh, really? Why is that?
Funny, I find it kinda hard to come out and say it.
You want me to wait in the kitchen?
No. No, baby, stay right where you are. God, you're gorgeous. And there's two of you.
The other end of town.
All right, thank you. They're very helpful.
You got a lock on those tracers?
Yep.
Thank you.
Negative right there.
Suspects are headed north on 88.
Have a close visual. Two male suspects.
Momentary visual of the suspect
crossing Big Wheeling Creek, heading north, northwest.
Thing gets 100 miles to the gallon. How much money is supposed to be out there?
It's supposed to be over 150 grand.
About a half mile north of Stone Run.
All right, boys, let's take a walk. Home to woods. Talk to someone in charge.
Right now, I'm the one in charge. What do you want?
Actually, we need to talk to Lieutenant Corby.
He's in the field. You got to come back tomorrow.
Can you page him? It's pretty important. Tell him it's John and I need to surrender.
Come surrender tomorrow. Today's not a good day.
Please, miss, what's your name?
Darian. Sergeant Darian.
Please, Sergeant Darian. It's very important.
All right. Let me see what I can do.
John who? Jonathan Storm?
Yes, sir. I'm at the police station. I need to talk to you right now.
You just stay where you are. All right, John, I'll be right there.
You're Jonathan Storm? The wanted one?
Yes, ma'am.
Freeze, motherfucker!
Well, hey, he came to turn himself...
Shut up!
You can relax, miss. I didn't do anything, all right?
Oh, yeah? Who killed Agent Blake, huh? And who burned that poor girl down at her house, huh? I'm the girl from the house.
You? Then what's going on here?
What do you got?
Got a thumbprint on the ignition key.
Is that it?
Yeah.
All right, can you put it in the ignition for me? Thank you.
Sir, do you think it's a good idea to write on the evidence?
On a day like this, I think it's a fantastic idea.
Miller.
Look what I found.
All right, so now what you're telling me is two men held a gun to your head and forced you to say John wasn't with you.
Yes, sir. And then John came in and, well, things got pretty ugly.
All right, so the burned body that we found...
It was one of the goons. The other man escaped and he stole my locket with John's picture in it.
Who killed Dave Blake?
Who knows? Look, Lieutenant, we were out singing and dancing that night. Nobody's gonna go sing and dance if they're gonna kill someone.
And what do you know about killing somebody?
Nothing. Hey, you know, hey.
Shut up.
All right.
What do you got for me?
Well, we got a match. I cross-referenced the fingerprint on the motorcycle key through the DMV, and that's what I got.
Dominic Bronson.
Excuse me, Lieutenant. I think we got a strong lead on that Walmart robbery.
All right, I'll be right there.
I don't want either one of you leaving town, you understand me? This case ain't over. Now get out of here.
Don't you move! Fucking cop killer!
What the fuck?
On your back. I said don't resist me, you fuck!
I said don't fucking move, you piece of shit!
What the hell's going on here?
We found this in your attic.
And we found that in your basement. And I got this from his pocket, which he got from the girl.
What the hell are you talking about?
This is the way it goes. You killed Dave Blake and you make it look like the kid did it. So we go after the kid while you're ripping off the Walmart for 150 G's. That simple. And then you knock your partner off because, I don't know, because I'm guessing maybe you're a greedy son of a bitch, too.
This look familiar? Your prints are on everything, man.
Hey, I want to call my lawyer.
Boy, you fucking...
You better call Johnny Cochran, you piece of shit.
So are we gonna let this bottle sit here, or are we gonna turn it into a lamp?
You sure this is the right house?
Absolutely. Swear to God.
We haven't started anything yet.
That some bitch better not be lying to me.
He swears to God.
Howdy, officers. May I help you?
Yeah. Yeah, you can help us. Anybody live in this house?
Nobody. This house I keep for rent. It's empty, 3 months.
Well, can we take a look inside?
Go ahead. It is very open.
Oh, very open. Well, very good.
Ah, thank you very much.
I knew it. That son of a bitch.
Ghost town, boss.
What do you have to say about the robbery, Bronson?
Bronson!
How did you know about the cash transport at Walmart?
Do you have any comments?
Man, I don't know what you're talking about.
By whom?
Yeah, Dominic, what happened to the money?
They recovered less than $50,000 from Dominic's house. But he was still convicted of the murder and the robbery.
Come on, let's go.
Come on, Bronson.
When I went to prison, I lost my scholarship. As a drug felon, I can no longer get government grants or loans for education. I couldn't even vote if there was someone worth voting for. Still, I can't complain. I had left home to become a student. I returned with an education that would last me a lifetime.
Anyone want to go to Jamaica, Mon?
Do you think people who smoke marijuana should be sent to prison?
That's a tough one. For medicinal purposes, no.
Do you think that the government is winning the war on drugs?
No.
Do you think that people that smoke marijuana should be sent to prison?
No.
Do you think people that sell marijuana should be sent to prison?
Yeah.
Why?
It's illegal.
Do you think that in states where the people vote to have marijuana for medical use under the supervision of doctors,
they should have that.
Do you think that the government is winning the war on drugs the way they're fighting it right now?
No.
Do you think that people that smoke marijuana should be put in prison?
Absolutely not. Should be put in prison? Oh,
I'll get to you in a second.
I'm sorry, I misunderstood the question.
Do you think people that smoke marijuana should be put in prison?
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
Bill Clinton should be right with
them. Okay. Do you think that people that smoke marijuana should be sent to prison?
Absolutely not.
So you don't think that the federal government... Do you think the federal government should enforce the marijuana laws in states where the people have voted on the ballot to allow medical use?
Decidedly not. As you know, in the District of Columbia, the vote was to allow marijuana to be used, but the Congress did not allow that information to be made public.
Do you think that the U.S. government is winning the war on drugs?
Well, obviously not. I mean, I think the whole strategy is wrong.
And
I'm with the Columbia Action Committee, and right now the United States is claiming that the intervention in Columbia is about drugs, but the reality is they're conspiring with right-wing paramilitary organizations that have a lot more to do with drug dealing than the guerrillas that they're fighting in Columbia. So it just doesn't add up. In general, I don't think that people in the United States smoking marijuana should be the government's number one target. I think things like poverty and the wealth gap and the fact that there are so many millions of Americans without health care might be better places to put our resources than prosecuting people who use drugs recreationally.
Do you think that the government is winning the war on drugs?
No.
Do you think that the government can win the war on drugs?
Possibly.
What do you think would be the best way to go about that?
I think what people need is stiffer penalties. Stiffer penalties and more rehab.
Do you think that people that smoke marijuana should be sent to prison?
No.
Do you think that people that sell marijuana should be sent to prison?
Yes, I do.
Why is that?
Because
It's against the law.
Do you think we're winning the war on drugs, sir?
No, I think the war on drugs is tearing the country apart. It's doing tremendous damage. And really have to do something about turning it around.
Do you think that we're winning the war on drugs the way we're fighting it right now?
Of course not.
Okay.
It's an endless war that I'm not sure it can ever be won. If you legalize them or not, I don't know if there's an answer to the war on drugs, ever.
Well, do you think that it's the federal government's place to prosecute people in states where the people have voted to make marijuana legal for medical use?
No, I don't think the federal government should stick its nose in any kind of state business. That's an overriding rule. That's not a good idea. The Constitution is called on states' rights, not federal rights.
Do you think that the United States government is winning the war on drugs?
That's got to be a joke.
So you don't think they're winning the war on drugs?
Well, I think if you look at the history of this war for, 75 years now, I would say it's the longest unwon war that we've ever had. So, no, I don't think so.
Do you think that people that smoke marijuana should be sent to prison?
No.
I think marijuana should be
sent. Do you think that people that sell marijuana should be sent to prison?
No.
Thing is, I've talked to a lot of Republicans out here, and they seem to agree with you.
Yeah, they just don't have the nerve to say it because, see, the religious right has demonized everything. Everything's evil. So they're afraid of getting smacked on the hand, if they say they're real offended. No, I used to, when I was younger, I did smoke, and I don't now, but I'd rather my kids do marijuana than alcohol. Because, I don't think it's heaven for me. When I quit, I just quit. It wasn't a problem. And it doesn't make you mean. It doesn't, make you stumble all over the place. I just don't get it. I really don't. I just do not get it. And I think the drinking age should be lowered. If you're old enough to go to war, you're old enough to drink a beer. And people y'all's age could change all that, Everybody's just scared. Scared of what? I don't know. I'm scared of not going against the religious right. They want to put their morals, they really don't have any morals. If they did, they wouldn't have done it the way they did. But they want to put their values on everybody to show them that they're going. We're just not going to have it. It takes guns and strings, it takes
more. And you think that you're in the majority? The majority of the people feel that the way
you are. They're just too scared to sneak out. This is what democracy looks like. That is what the police state looks like. This is what democracy looks like. That is what the police state looks like. This is what democracy looks like.
Hey, on the 4th of July, they all marched up the canyon, praying the silver guys. To call the desk of that wall, yeah, too many pictures. And I believe in God as I hear the drummers call. Hey, I look up, look down, dance yourselves around and around. Cause I look up, look down, happiness is bliss when you're feeling the ground. And I believe in God as I hear.
this is the end.